Hello everyone, and welcome to Expressions of Faith with Judith. Thank you so much for watching, and please, you guys, subscribe, share, and if this video is a blessing to you, please give it a thumbs up. I am so glad you are here today. Thank you so much for joining me. I pray all is well with you and your families and that you have had a great day today. Today I am doing week two of Illustrated Faith devotional kit, Mess to Message. And this week, the title is Masterpiece, and it's coming from the book of Nehemiah, Mess to Masterpiece. LaQuisha writes, "Do you have a mindset to work? Have you ever built anything from start to finish? Have you ever created what you would call a masterpiece? Have you ever been a catalyst for a positive movement? If you started a movement, have you ever looked down at your hands and asked God to strengthen them for the work ahead?" Nehemiah worked as a cupbearer to the Persian king. He received a report that his native land, Judah, was not doing well. After praying, Nehemiah requested of the king to go back home and help. He left with a special letter of protection from the king due to his strong desire to go where he believed God was telling him to go. Along his journey, he encountered those who didn't want to see the rebuilding of Judah. Nehemiah showed his protection letter and kept moving. He organized people in the community to collectively come together and rebuild the broken wall. Even after several attacks, Nehemiah believed in the outcome so much that he prayed to God, "Now strengthen my hands." Eventually, the walls are built and dedicated to God in a beautiful celebration. After overcoming challenges in my childhood, I developed a mindset to work and asked God to strengthen my hands in the work of rebuilding young ladies. I started a mentoring program with 10 teenagers who loved the experience. I was excited about the great results in the early years and established the program further. However, doubt crept in. 2 years into the work, I was mentoring 40 girls 2 days a week, complete with snacks, purchased with my personal funds, and fresh ideas that would require more hands on deck. I was practically begging for donations online and constantly seeking mentors. Despite my doubts, I continued building the girls who trusted me with their secrets and their hearts. I held on tight to God's protection as I experienced over and over with I failed that no matter how much money or time I spent, He strengthened my hands for the work and provided all my needs. As of 2021, Queendom TEA, the Adequate Academy, is 14 years old and has served over 1,000 girls locally and abroad. I am especially grateful each time an adult who was once my teen mentee reaches out to me to share her accomplishments. What a masterpiece to behold. Will you step forward to be the organizer of a great rebuilding? Whether it is in your mind, your family, your school, or your community, God will strengthen your hands to do the work. Don't stop when the enemy creeps in with doubts or comes along to raid your progress. Keep building, keep painting, keep singing, keep smiling at the coworker who won't smile back. Keep working on your plan to write a book or start a business or nonprofit. In time, your wall will rise from the rubble and you will be able to stand back victoriously and gaze upon the work of your hands. When you go where God tells you to go, not only will you go with protection, but results will be a masterpiece. Oh, what an awesome testimony of God's faithfulness from LaQuisha. This devotional is blessing my life. It's blessing my whole soul, y'all. I would encourage you guys to go to illustratedfaith.com and pick this devotional up. You will not regret it. It is so encouraging and inspiring. Has God given you work to do? Or let me put it another way. What work has God given you to do? Because each one of us has a purpose on this earth to fulfill, a divine purpose. What is your purpose? Why were you born? Are you focusing on fulfilling that purpose? Is everything you're spending your time doing in line with what God put in your hands to do? I hope so, you guys. And if you do not know the work that God has put in your hands to do, seek God, because that's the only way you're going to find out. Your life is hidden in Christ. And the only way you can find out what your purpose is on this earth is you have to seek Christ. You can't find it any other way. Somebody may be able to bring a word of confirmation after God has spoken to you. But you must find out why you were created from the Creator Himself. The Bible says in Romans chapter 12, verse 2, do not be conformed to this world, this age, fashioned after and adapted to its external, superficial customs, but be transformed, changed by the entire renewal of your mind, by its new ideals and its new attitude, so that you may prove for yourselves what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God, even the thing which is good and acceptable and perfect in His sight for you. Oh, yes, when we renew our minds in the Word of God, in the presence of God, in prayer, our minds will be transformed into the image of Christ. And then and only then will we be able to discern the will of God for our lives, that good and acceptable and perfect will of God concerning you. Yes, God has a perfect will of God concerning you. He has a work He has put in your hands for you to complete on this earth. I heard a great preacher say, and I quote, to find the will of God is the greatest discovery on earth. To know the will of God is the greatest knowledge on earth. And to fulfill the will of God is the greatest achievement on earth. Wow. That is wisdom. That is wisdom. I don't care what else you accomplish, what else you discover in this life. The greatest discovery is to find the will of God. I don't care how many master degrees you have, or PhDs, or whatever. The greatest knowledge on earth is to know the will of God. And no matter what we achieve, and we may be applauded for our achievements, to fulfill the will of God is the greatest achievement on earth. This devotional by LaQuisha has blessed my whole soul, you guys. God is so good. He knows what to put in our hands at the right time and in the right season. He is awesome, y'all. I thank you so much for watching. Be encouraged. Praise the Lord. Keep your mind on Him and your focus on Him and His purpose for your life. And remember, it's all about Jesus. It's all about Him. Until next time, bye-bye.